Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa afdalus salati wa atammut taslimi ala al-mab'uthi rahmatan lil alamin Muhammad ibn Abdillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man ihtada bi sunnatihi ila yawmiddin. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahbab, when it comes to the words, the verbs part of me that we're going to be covering, we're going to use a particular reference to look at what the linguistic meaning is. So the reference that we're focusing on is known in the Arabic language by Mu'jim Maqayis al-Lugha. It is basically the encyclopedia that focuses on the core root letters of the Arabic language. And it is written by Abil Hussein Ahmed ibn Faris ibn Zakariya ibn Habib al-Razi, or better known as Ibn Faris. This dictionary of his is amazing. It is beautiful in that it's unique. And what he does is he basically takes the three core letters that are the root letters, and then he tells you basically what they hold of the linguistic meaning. And if it's just one meaning that it has, he'll mention that. If it's two particular meanings that those core letters have, he'll do that. And from this point, what we're going to do is basically understand that if we are able to recognize what those three root core letters are, then no matter what derivative, what form, whether it's a different verb form or a noun form, as long as we're able to recognize those three root letters, we'll then be able to understand that that word has something to do with the particular meaning of the three root letters at hand. And inshallah ta'ala, as we basically go through this process, inshallah ta'ala, we'll better come to understand the methodology as a whole of what we're doing for this course and what it is that Ibn Faris, rahmatullahi alayhi, what he's done for the Arabic language. This great scholar is somebody that has written extensively. He died, most correctly said, to be around 395 Hijri. He is from, said to be born in the city of Ar-Ray, which is basically in proper day today, Iran. But Iran wasn't Iran back in those days. Those were Ma-Wara al-Nahr, the Persian lands as a whole. And alhamdulillah, the book itself is something that is fantastic. Hopefully, as you get to better understand this, inshallah ta'ala, you'll be able to utilize it yourself as a reference for you in strengthening your language skills as a whole. So, inshallah ta'ala, be prepared as we embark on the first of the verbs. And inshallah ta'ala, from that point on, we move forward.